Hi everyone, welcome to a new Begijnhoeve video. My name is Tommie.
My name is Rob, and today we're going to do a how-to together. So this is going to be a how-to not get a divorce between two partners while training. Now this is a how-to get your horse more in balance. This is Karma. This is a 5-year-old Desperado mare. Very sweet mare, very hot mare. I think she's very promising for the future, and yeah, we're going to train her, so let's see how it goes.
Vamos! So the first thing we're going to talk about is what we already show you in one of the first how-tos, how to warm up. It's very important that that you can warm up your horse as easy as she can for the moment. Where it's very important that you immediately already start to balance your horse. What do we mean by that is that the horse is not leaning in your hand, running away, that you have to give leg all the time to support her, so that she really can warm up on her own legs, and yeah, that it's easy. That's the number one.
So easy, so easy. Wow.
A little bit more when it's good, open the neck more. So when you make a correction and you see the horse get a little bit more short in the neck, which is not a big deal, but the goal at the end is always to find the opening in the neck again, and that she wants to walk towards your hand. Now I have the idea that she's coming a little bit too much behind the bit, so then you need to do something with just that's already better. Yeah. And there he went forward, and because he went forward, then the neck got more open, so that was good. Open him a little bit more. And then a little bit lag, that she, yeah. Good, that's better. And then if you want, if the position and the balance in the forward is good, you can go back. So every time play a little bit with your speed to figure out, that's good. And then give again. And then she's not allowed to run away. There she goes fast because you put your hand forward. That's good. Slow down and soft your hand. And then she needs to wait. If it takes too long, you can make a transition to halt. And yeah. So it's very important that if you ride and you want to, when you ask your horse something, that it doesn't take too long before you get a reaction. If it takes too long, then you need to make a decision. So if you want to slow down, and for example, after a few meters she still didn't listen, then you need to make a transition, in this case to halt. And then you go forward again. Because if you keep trying, then you see that she's a little bit walking through your hand, which means she doesn't listen well enough to the rein aids. And then she becomes shorter in the neck instead of slowing down on the right way. No. And okay, soft your hand first. So in the beginning, the position of the head is not so important. Many times when you make good transitions, the position will be fine eventually. So now it's very important that you first have the speed control. Now he's a little bit too much down. I don't think you ask for it. So it's very important that you, when you have a moment, your horse do something which you don't want, or which you don't, what's not your goal, you should take her out of it immediately. Yeah, good. And then soft your hand. And then on your leg, you go forward. What are you trying now?
Well, as she stops.
Yeah, but in the beginning, when she's a little bit hot and excited, I think she's better go to forward first. And, like you want to make a halt, but then she's too active for the moment. It's a young horse. So you can also decide to do it a little bit later on in the training, when she already warmed up a little bit.
I thought you said I had to go back.
Yeah, but if it's too, if you get too much tension, then you should, I mean, you shouldn't have to do it perfectly immediately. So now soft your hand first, see what happens. If she runs away, you slow her down. I think she's going lower than you want. At least she's a little bit behind the bit. This is better. So open your hand, make the neck a little bit longer and see what she does. Yeah. And then if you want to go, I mean the walk now is good, so if you want to slow her down, that's fine, and slow her down and give. So soft your hand.
She's not responding.
Yeah, but she stopped first, she didn't listen to your rein ace, and then she stopped too much. So the goal is here that she slows down a little bit and that the hind legs keep going forward, that's better. Soft your hand again, see what happens. For me now, when you soft your hand, she lower her neck herself. I think you should go forward. Soft your hand. Yeah, good. And then first go forward, that she get a little bit more in front of you. So also when your horse is hot or very active, try to find the relaxation in the forward. Open the neck more. She's behind the bit too much. Yeah, that's better. And if she come up, then you can make her lower. But if you open your hand, you want her to follow and not stay too short and behind the bit. So if you feel in the beginning they want to run away already too much, then you have two options. That's the better option, yeah. Just let her go if she run away, then make a transition. But don't cut in the trap that you hold her all the time, so she gets only short in the neck and actually still running through your hand. So it's better, yeah, and now make the neck longer. If she run away, you go to walk. Go to walk. And then first long neck and relaxed. That's better. And then good. Soft your hand. And yeah, good so. And now trot. Soft your hand. That's better. And then make a transition to walk. And you see it's not perfect yet, but it's okay. It's just the beginning. Yeah, but you have to. Good. And relax and make a transition to trot. Soft your hand. I don't care if it's not perfect. Lower your hands. Good. Try to find the relaxation. Good. And every time, even when you feel it's difficult, try to open the neck and stretch the neck down.
So I did warm up Karma, she's a very hot horse, so now I want to make her a little bit stronger, so I'll pick her up a little bit and I'm going to do transitions and I want her to be more in balance.
Soft your hand when you make a transition to trot. So when the horse gets up in the neck and you feel that she gets blocked a little bit, make her a little rounder and a lower. And then it's important that you feel that she's not becoming behind the bit. Lower, a little bit lower. Yeah. And then soft your hand. Even when you feel it's not possible. Yeah, that's better. Yeah. And then soft your hand again. Soft your hand first. Now she's behind the bit. Yeah. So that's difficult with the young horse, to have the right connection and the very right position of the head, because one moment they come too much up, one moment they come too much down. Every time when you feel there is something not like you want it, you need to correct it slowly and a little bit. So the fun part in dressage is that if you make transitions, for example, in the trot itself, you can make the trot a little bit more expressive. So you can teach the horse to have more energy and more going uphill by making the right transitions in the trot itself. So what you do, go forward. Yeah. So now you see the trot is kind of normal and easy and simple, which is really good. Then you're going to try to make some transitions in the trot where you want, what the goal is, if you touch the leg, The horse reacts in the hind legs, which means that the hind legs are going to make bigger steps, and that in the end she will learn not to go faster but bigger in her gait on the leg. So that's what we're going to practice now. So soften your hand first, don't let her become behind the bit, and you feel that she's swinging from left to the right, it's too much backward, this is good. Yeah. So when you go too much back and you lose the forward tendency, they go swinging. You always need to go a little bit forward then, like now, a little bit. Yeah. Hands together.
Oh, she did it herself.
Yeah, that's good. But this is good. This is good. So now you slow down a little bit, not too much. That's enough, that's enough. And then make her, you can also make her wait in a higher speed, so you don't always have to go so slow that she loses the balance a little bit. Try to feel a little, that's the difficult part from balancing. This is really nice. This is, keep this trot for a little while. Yeah, it's also good for a horse that you can hold the same speed, the same rhythm and the same trot for a little bit longer. You also have to practice that. Good, and go forward a little bit. Okay, that's fine. Good, soft your hand a little bit, go forward. Also when you make a circle or another line, you can go forward. Good. First soften your hands, see what happens. Does she find her own balance? Good. And then slow her down a little bit. Not too much, just slowly. Then soft your hand. If she waits, give leg. Give leg. Very good, super. And slow down. Step by step, not too much in one time. Good. So it's a five-year-old horse, so it's important that you don't bring her back too much and too quick, because then she loses the activity from behind, where it gets more difficult. So you do it more step by step. That's really nice. Now you slow her down again, just a little bit first, see what you have, then soft your hand and give a little bit leg, because now she's coming too much off the bit, in my opinion. Give a little bit leg, a little bit. Yeah, really good. And now you slow her down already. Yeah, good. And now you give leg. Give leg. Very good. Very good. And now slow down a little bit. Ooh. And forward. Yeah, good. Change rein. That's better. So by playing with this speed in the trot, you can actually make the trot have bigger paces. And that's at the end what you want, by balancing your horse. That's very important. And now slow down, slow her down, soft your hand. Don't let her fall into the right shoulder all the time. Keep her straight, shoulders to the left. Yeah, good, very good. Now you give leg, she went forward and she make bigger steps. That's what you want. If you feel she come behind a bit, better speed her up, that she goes up, because she's in front of the leg instead of making corrections with your hands. Yeah, soft your hand first, before you give leg.
Oh.
Give, and slow down now.
Oh, slow.
Yeah, because she,
forward.
But she was already running.
Oh, that's what I did.
Okay, first make sure that you really can give without her running away. So demonstrate. So test, can I give? Can you give? She's not going faster or slower. Yeah, see, that's already. And that's also a difficult thing in the dressage when the training, you make some transitions in the trot itself, and what happened then, the horse already understands what's going on. So what you do, you make a variation in those speed transitions all the time. If your horse already thinks, oh, now I need to go forward, you don't do it. If you bring her back and you relax and you do nothing, she stops what she did over there, then you know you need to go forward. So the variation of the training is very important. So also with the speed control thing, don't do it every time at the same moment. So now you went forward, so now give a little bit and see what happens. Stay like this for a little bit, stay like this, and now slow down. Good. That's really good. Now you slowed her down. That was really nice. She immediately gives a good reaction on the rein, and she kept swinging from the behind leg through the back, and she stayed in balance. I really like that transition. That's much better. Good. And slow her down again. So, and if you did that a few times, you can make a transition to walk in between. Now she's behind the bit. That was too much back. This is better. Lower. Very good. Yeah. Okay. Okay. And now slow her down. Good. Good. Hands down. Good. And make a transition to walk and relax her for a minute. Forward. Good. So one of the questions of you guys was, how can I make my horse make a bigger trot or towards an extended trot? So what you've seen before now is that we make some transitions. And again, I'm going to say it again, the transitions are the key. So now we're going to try to do it a little more in the trot itself and see what we can do already to make the trot a little bit more expressive. So first you feel if you can have a nice easy trot where it is not too difficult to just trot normal. That was good. And then when you feel, first you need to feel the balance. That's really good. And from this point you can do whatever you want, but this is first your basic balance. It's easy, it's simple. Good. So that's good. So if you have the feeling that you can relax your hand, she's not running away, then you give leg. And what you want...
Oh, she was running away.
Yeah, if you do hoe, which was really good, don't do too much hoe that she get off the bit again. It's the you really need to feel how much effort you need to put in it to get her, to get it done. And if you overcorrect it, it's always also difficult. This is really nice trot, by the way. Really nice. Don't do anything. Super. Hands low. Really good. Very good. This trot I really like as a basic trot. It's super. So now try to slow her down a little bit. Not too much. And now give leg. Now. Yeah. Good. And slow down.
Yeah, just falling a little
and
bit.
And now leg. Now leg. Now leg. Now leg. A little bit too late. It's okay. Just to show what it does if you, good, and now you give a little bit leg, a little bit, good, very good, and slow down, and slow down. Ooh. Because now you get more reaction, so after a few steps she starts running, you bring her back again, and when she gets stronger and stronger in the hind legs, she will eventually learn to have that trot longer than 10 meters. But this is with the young horse. Slow down a little bit and give leg. Very good. Very good. And now slow down a little bit. Ooh. And give leg. Now. 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 Super. That's it. See, now you already get a little bit more power in the trot without losing the control. This is really good. Yeah, good. Lower your hands a little bit. Sit easy. Very good. Now, when you feel it's easy, you're going to try to do something with the speed again. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit. Very good. And slow down. Super. Because now you saw in the beginning, instead of having bigger trots, she was running and get quicker. So sometimes, in this case, it happened because she didn't react well enough to the leg. So then you continuing to going forward until she make this good reaction in the hind leg. So she really understands she's not allowed to run, but she has to make a bigger steps from the hind leg. That's very important. You did it a few times only in the trot to make the trot bigger and more powerful. Well, what happened after a few minutes, she lose the balance too much, or she doesn't listen well enough anymore. So then you go back to the transitions again, trot, walk, and walk trot, and when that's easy again, you can do it again in the trot itself. And this is how you build up strength and muscles and balance with your young horse. Good. And slow down and give a little bit leg. Very good. And slow down again. Slow down. So if she's going to react so good what she does now, you try to slow her down sooner so that you have 3 of those nice steps instead of 12 meters. Very good. Slow down. Now she's running a little bit too much. Slow down. And now a little bit leg. Ja, braaf. Very good. And then hands soft. Leg. Yeah. Slow down. And leg. Braaf. Slow down. Ooh. Don't go too much forward. Good. Very good. Leg. A little bit. Good, good now leg, now. Very good. Now you were on time, you brought her back, and before she could get off the bit, you were already going forward. That was really good. That's really important in balancing your horse, the timing that you do it on the right moment. Now she's running away a little bit too much. She's going down in the front instead of up an uphill tendency. Slow down, slow down, soft your hand and give a little bit lag. Very good. And now slow down already, slow down, very good. And now give lag and slow down and give lag. Give lag, give lag. Very good, brav, super. So you see you can already make now three times on one side transitions. And the more educated your horse will be, the more you can make those small transitions, the bigger the trot and the more balanced your horse will be. That was really nice. So guys, thank you for watching this video.
She wants to do another one.
She's still pretty excited. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Thumbs up if you like it. And don't forget to subscribe.
See you.
Zullen we nog even één keer opnieuw doen, want deze was echt stom.
So guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it and you thought it was interesting. If you have any more questions, leave them below in the comments. Maybe we can make a new video about it. Don't forget that like button and really don't forget to subscribe.
See you next video.
See you. Bye bye.